everyone, this is Dave Kemp with Dotry Products, and today's talking PowerPoint is going to address standard precautions issued by the Center for Disease Control and Prevention. These five guidelines are relatively straightforward and can be easily integrated in the audiology clinical setting. To start, we're going to look at appropriate personal barriers. Wear gloves, masks, eye protection, and other personal barriers when needed, if performing a procedure that may potentially expose you directly or indirectly to blood, ear drainage, mucus, cerumen, saliva, or any other potentially infectious substance, take necessary precautions. Wash your hands. This is the most important thing you can do to minimize the spread of disease. Wash prior to and after patient appointments, immediately after glove removal, and as needed. Clean and disinfect surfaces, such as tables and armrests, after each patient appointment with a disinfectant. Clean and sterilize any reusable instrument that is inserted in the ear canal, contaminated with blood, blood byproducts, ear drainage, and the like, and or can penetrate the skin from use or misuse. Last, dispose of sharp instruments in a sharps container. Everything else may be thrown in the regular waste receptacle, although anything with copious amounts of blood, cerumen, drainage, and the like should be placed in a biohazard bag and then in the regular trash. For more in-depth information on implementing a comprehensive infection control plan, check out Infection Control in the Audiology Clinic and Infection Control for Speech-Language Pathology. That's all for today. Thanks for watching. Sayonara.